Joining me now is Josh Shapiro, the Attorney General of Pennsylvania. AG Shapiro, I know nearly every state currently undergoing some kind of reckoning with this suppression threat, whether it's suppressive legislation or one of these cynical audits to undermine a settled election, or in the case of states like Georgia, both. And it appears now that Republicans in your state, some of whom visited the Arizona audit, may be attempting to replicate what they saw there. But in your state's case, there are also some state GOP leaders basically saying enough is enough, not here. What's your take on this, sir?
Well, Rev, we really have become the epicenter now here in Pennsylvania, and it's a continuation of the work they've been trying to do over the past year. Remember, just prior to the election, there were 19 different lawsuits that were filed to make it harder for people to vote. We beat back every single one of them. And then after the votes were cast, there were more than 20 lawsuits filed to make it harder for certain people's votes to count. Now what you're seeing is a continuation of that effort to try and make it harder for people to access the polls and to go back and relitigate an election that was safe and secure here in Pennsylvania that Joe Biden won and Donald Trump lost. And let's be very clear. Let's speak some truth here, Rev. They're not trying to make it harder for people who look like me to vote in Pennsylvania. They're trying to make it harder for our black and brown communities to be heard at the ballot box. This is central to our democracy. This is central to who we are as Americans. And we cannot allow voting rights to become a partisan exercise or a partisan errand for Donald Trump.
Now, AG Shapiro, we had the Wisconsin Attorney General with us last night on this show. As he faces a push for one of these false audits in his own state, are you aware of or participating in any concerted effort by state attorney generals to push back against these fake probes?
Well, I talk to my fellow attorneys general all the time, including General Call from Wisconsin. But let's talk about what's really happened here in Pennsylvania. After the votes were cast and tallied, we had two separate audits in Pennsylvania. Nearly every one of our 67 counties went through a full audit. And in addition to that, by law, we're required to go over 2,000 ballots in each and every county to make sure that there were no issues. And in fact, there were no issues. What they're talking about bringing here to Pennsylvania, what they're doing in Arizona right now, is a sham. And let me be very clear. If these lawmakers try to do here in Pennsylvania what they're doing in Arizona, they will have to go through me and they will lose. They will not succeed in overturning the election or undermining our democracy.
Well, what kind of help do you need? What are you hoping to see come out of this White House initiative on voting rights announced last week to be led by Vice President Kamala Harris? I mean, where do AGs of state AGs need executive assistance while Congress fights its own fight over voter protection bills?
Look, I'm so happy that the vice president is leading this effort, that she's been tapped by the president to do it. I've been friends with the vice president for more than 15 years. She is obviously up to the task. She understands these issues in her core. But I would just say that right now, these voting rights battles, they're happening in the states, not in Washington, D.C. This is where the litigation's happening. This is where they're trying to pass the same bills that they passed into law in Georgia and Texas and elsewhere. They're trying to do it here in Pennsylvania. They're trying to do it in other states. And we need to make sure that we battle it back at the state level. Thankfully, we have a Democratic governor here who would veto any of those bills if they ever made it to his desk. But the battle is in the states. And what I need right now, number one, is strong support from the vice president, which I know we will get. And number two, I need to hear from the American people. The American people need to speak up. They need to contact their state lawmakers. They need to know if they are functioning as Donald Trump's errand boy or they're functioning on behalf of our democracy. People need to rise up, because here's the thing, Rev. We can't have honest debates over infrastructure, tax policy, healthcare policy, you name it, if at the end of the day, certain voices aren't going to count in our democracy. And right now here in Pennsylvania, you have the leadership of the Republican Party, the people who are, you know, the leading statewide candidates saying that they want to do Donald Trump's bidding and make it harder for people to vote. people of Pennsylvania, the people across this country need to rise up and say they're not going to take it.
As state attorney general, would you block in any and any electoral audit, let me put it that way, if Republican lawmakers ultimately attempt one? And what are your options for doing so, Mr. Shapiro?
Sure. Well, as we talked about before, we've already had two legitimate audits based on the law. But if lawmakers in Harrisburg try and do what they're doing in Arizona, right, just to carry out your question here, they would, in theory, need to use their subpoena power in order to subpoena the counties to get access to some of those ballots. And I would expect that that would be litigated, and you should expect, the American people and, of course, the people of Pennsylvania should expect, I'll fight back against that. And when I go to court to defend the rights of the voters here in Pennsylvania, I win. And I'll win again if we have to defend our democracy.
All right. Thank you, Attorney General Josh Shapiro.